And hello everyone, this is Warlord once again, and today we're going to be talking about batch painting. Now, when you're doing War of the Ring, since you're doing mass battles, it's not like you're doing one or two figures like you would for other games like, you know, 40K when you're doing one of your Warlords or your Heroes, or even in Lord of the Rings if you want to get, you know, that Saruman or that Gandalf to look really good or one of the others. Batch painting is essentially when you want to do battles like these. These are my figures of, you know, large armies. You're going to have to do, you know, more than one or two figures at a time. So I usually do a box at a time. And, you know, most of the boxes that I have painted and what I still need to paint are the old Games Workshop boxes, which were 24 figures each for the plastics. When I do metals, it's the same thing. I try and do 15 at a time, such as you see these knights here from... you know, the Rohan Knights. So essentially what you need to do, you got to do a figure over a long period of time and just do one color a night. That's what I usually do. About 30 minutes is usually what I do, no more than an hour. So I got my start in wargaming from Napoleonics, mostly in 15 millimeter. And here's a picture of some of my 15 millimeter Napoleonics that I'm getting ready to paint. I do them in batches of 24. And also I got some 28 millimeter black and tans from the Irish Wars. Also, it's about 10 for 28 millimeter. So here's what you really need to do. You need to start off with a primer. I have a white primer here that I'm using. For Rohan, because you want to do for your lighter colors, you want to do white. For orcs, I'd probably use a black primer. And you can see that you want to get the primer all over the figure. I mean, not coat it so much where you know, the paint is just, you know, way too much on the figure, but just a light coat of primer. And then what I do, it's kind of like you dressing them. You're dressing yourself. I start with the skin and work my way up. Now, the skin here, I use a flesh wash first, and then I dry brush a flesh on top of it. Why? That's what I started to do 10 years ago. I used to just do straight flesh, and then with this particular flesh wash, it was kind of dark, so I decided to do the flesh wash first. I do it differently now, but I want to keep all my figures looking the same. So what I do on top of the flesh wash is I dry brush the flesh. And you can see the effects here. You know, with the newer flesh washes, I think they're a lot better, particularly the Games War or the Citadel brand. So what you can do, you can put your flesh on first and then put your flesh wash on top of that. And you can see either the dark recesses of the model, as well as the flesh brings out the highlights in the model as well. Now, the flesh I use, it's an older flesh. It's a Ralph Hartha flesh. And it's just because I've had it for that long. I've had this paint for 20 years. I just keep adding water to it, and it still seems to work. So there's some other fleshes out now with the new Citadel colors, a lot better. But I'm trying to keep all my figures looking the same, and that's one thing you need to do when you do batches. So, all right, so from here, I'm going to do the armor. Now, since I started out with a white base coat, I'm going to have to paint the armor black first and then dry brush over it with a metal. So here's the Abaddon Black. I still think that's what it's called. And so I just find where the armor is on the figure, because the rest of the model, I still want those lighter colors to show up really well, not too dark. And then I dry brush bolt gun metal on top of it. Yes, I still have some bolt gun metal lying around. I know some of the newer paints, they've changed it, but the Citadel has a conversion chart. Or if you want to do yours more shiny, I like my Rohan Knights to have a little bit of a dull look. And if I get too much bolt gun or metal on the model, what I'll do, a little of a black wash to kind of dull it down a little bit, depending on the model. All right, so now you want to start with your base coat. Now for Rohan, that's going to be brown. This is Rhinox Hide. It used to be called Scorched Brown. For Rohan, what I did, I start with the dark first, the dark browns, and then I add layers of light brown, because with Rohan, you're going to have you know, a mixture of the browns and the greens, but you want each successive layer of brown to show up. So I start off with the dark one first, and then I'm going to put on a Morphang Brown. I believe that's how you called it. It used to be called Bestial Brown. And this is for the undergarments, actually. So I have the undergarments are this lighter Morphang Brown, and then on top of that, The outer layers of clothing, I have the scorched brown to give it more of a layered look. And you can see where I have, you know, on the undershirts, I have this Morphrang brown color. And then I just keep adding on top of it. Now, the next thing you want to do is you probably want to do a larger piece. So I did the cloaks. Now, here I use the same technique I used before. I'm using a green ink first, and then I'm going to use Dark Angel's green. Because you have to remember, when I started doing these 10 years ago, or my Rohan army 10 years ago, these were the colors I had to work with, and I'm trying to get them all look the same. I started off with green, Dark Angel's green, but I could see patches of white underneath. So what I did is I started to use this green ink to get in all the recesses, and then I would paint the Dark Angel's green on top of it, and you get this dark look that you see here. Now, I will highlight on top of this, to actually bring out some of the highlights, but some of the earlier models I did, you know, when I was painting a Dark Angel's green on the white primer, you know, you saw these white streaks. So here you don't see these white streaks because of that dark green ink. Some people will do the opposite, but since I based in white primer, this is a technique that I used. If I did it in black, it would be different. So here I am doing a highlight on top of the cloaks. This is one of the lighter greens. I think it's goblin green. I might have a picture of it. I'm not really sure. But that's essentially all I do with the cloaks. And then I'll do the next large piece I need to do. Now, for Rohan, I used a dark flesh. I still have some of that lying around, and I use these for some of the shields, as well as the spears and the bows. So basically any woodwork in order to, you know, countershade the bestial brown, the Morphag brown, I use the dark flesh, and this is based off of a paint scheme. I think it came out in the Journey books, with the Two Towers Journey books, because you want your Rohan to have a little bit of a militia look. I mean, yeah, you want them all to look the same, but, you know, the box art had the two different colors, the brown shields and the green shield. So I just painted a straight dark flesh here on these areas. And then I did the hair. The hair, I believe I used a venom brown first, and then I dry brushed bronze flesh on top of that. As well as I did a bleach bone on the arrows, the arrow feathers, as you can see, or I started to on some of the arrow feathers. You'll see in some upcoming pictures what I did with that. And then I just started building there, and I did some bleach bone on the arrow feathers and the shield boss. And this is because the shield boss is white. Now, if you paint white on a dark color, you're going to see that dark color underneath. So you need to kind of layer it. So here's where I used the bleach bone. And this is also, I think, it came from, you know, a Games Workshop paint scheme. And then once the bleach bone has dried, you know, 24 hours later, because I'm only doing one color a day, you know, I put on the white. And you'll see what the white looks like here. This is White Scar. It used to be called Skull White, whatever you have lying around. And you can see I did the Rohan flag, as well as the shield bosses in white. Now, you're going to, you know, streak over a little bit. So my final touch, I kind of do each color all over again, and I do over my mistakes. You're going to make mistakes. You can correct them at the end process, and that's essentially what I did here. Is that, you know, I took all the colors from the scorched brown, the dark angel's green, and the, you know, the dark flesh and the white, and, you know, wherever I made a mistake, I went ahead and I fixed my mistake. So that's one good thing about painting, is that you can fix your mistakes. And so now I'm getting ready to do my base. So with the base, what I've done with all my Lord of the Rings, I used scorched brown. I know when the original Fellowship came out, they were telling you to use a bestial brown. So I started to use a darker brown instead, and I think it looks pretty good. I did some final touches here with the metal before I did that. This looks like I've done some bolt gun metal on the swords, and also the gold on the helmet rims, as well as on the shield, and then I corrected any mistakes. I usually do my metals last because, you know, they're usually they're the last things that usually show up on a figure. So I kind of like work my way dark to light to the metals. So and here, so you can see, I'm doing my bases. I did some scorch brown here, or whatever it's called now. And then for the base itself, for my good, I do green flock, and I've just found on eBay some more of the old Citadel modeling flock, which I really like. So what I do, I know some people will use Elmer's glue or PVA glue, water down, and then put the flock on, but because I have this white underneath, what I do, I use a green paint, and then I while the paint is still wet, I dip it in the flock, and then I shake off the flock, and then once that's done, I'll add, you know, some accents on the modeling base as well. Here I just have a couple gravel pieces, you know, just because that's what I did 10 years ago. I could probably do some more elaborate bases, but I want my entire army to look the same, so I'm trying to copy some stuff I did 10 years ago. So there you go. All right, good luck with your batch painting.